Okay, so we've had a look at the structure of the Earth, and we had a quick look at Wegener's theory of continental drift. So in that we mentioned the plate tectonics. So Wegener thought that the Earth was like a giant jigsaw. All these pieces were once close together and then have drifted over many, many millions of years. This is the view we have today. There's the UK. And we're sitting on this big plate called the Eurasian plate, Europe effectively. And you'll see the Earth's just fragmented to all these different plates. Think of a hard-boiled egg. If you crack it, you see it on the surface, you've got all these individual little pieces of the jigsaw. Now, there are boundaries to these plates. And these boundaries are where the different plates meet. Sometimes the plates move side to side. Sometimes they move towards each other, sometimes they move apart, and that can cause problems. It can cause earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, and the plates are moving all the time. They're generally moving a few centimeters every year, which doesn't sound a lot, but over millions of years, that can be a substantial distance. So, movement's caused really because of heat, convection currents. So remember, the core of the Earth is very, very hot, and that's because of radioactive decay producing a lot of heat. And as the heat rises, it's causing these currents, little bit like in air, where the warm air rises and the cooler air falls because it's more dense. And what happens as these currents form, they encourage these fragmented pieces of rock here in the crust to move either side by side or apart or towards each other. So there's three types of boundaries, and the boundaries really are where these plates meet. You can see these dark lines here. So the first one we're going to look at, this one here. And this one is called a constructive plate. And what happens is the plates are moving apart from each other. You end up with this little gap here, and what happens? Magma rushes up through, and then eventually will cool down and solidify, and will form new rock. So this is where we can get new islands forming. We can have mountains forming as well. So that's called constructive. It's constructive because we're constructing new rock here. That's when the plates move apart. This is an interesting one where we get an oceanic plate, which is a plate sitting under the ocean, and we have a continental plate, which is just the land. Now, the oceanic plate is a lot heavier because it's got all that water pushing down on it. So what tends to happen is it tends to get pushed underneath this plate here. And we have this area here called the subduction zone. And that can cause a lot of friction, a lot of forces as they move and rub apart. That can cause things like earthquakes, which can then lead to tsunamis. This plate pushing down here can cause changes of pressure in magma chambers, which can force and cause volcanic eruptions. So that one's called a destructive plate because it's very destructive. This final one is called conservative plate boundary. So this is where you've actually got two plates side by side moving alongside each other. And you can find this in near California, Los Angeles, where they have a lot of earthquakes. So as these rub alongside each other, it causes a lot of friction. And sometimes they kind of snap out of position, and that energy is released in the form of an earthquake. So I mentioned about volcanic eruption, so I've got a quick video clip here. And this is Krakatoa. So this is in 2018. Krakatoa is found in Indonesia. So there's probably a buildup of pressure in the magma chamber below the volcano, and it's just been released. So this is just massive, massive clouds of ash. We talked about these plates where you get earthquakes. So there's a video clip of an earthquake. Some ground shaking. A massive amount of energy released.